I am Dr. Nagashree, working as an associate consultant in Obstetrics and Gynecology Department in Apollo Women's Hospital, Chennai. The present topic is successful laparoscopic management of cesarean scar pregnancy. This article has been published in IJSR in September 2018, and I am one of the authors. Next. Coming to a brief introduction, cesarean scar pregnancy is the rarest form of ectopic pregnancies. The incidence is around 1 is to 1800 to 1 is to 2216 in women with an ectopic pregnancy. A scar pregnancy is defined as when the gestational sac is implanted in the myometrium at the site of a previous cesarean section. Timely recognition of the salient sonographic findings is critical. Next. Hereby we report a case of Ravida 8 with a history of two live children, two cesarean sections. She had three first trimester terminations and two were spontaneous abortions. She had dilatation and curettage for all of them. Presently diagnosed is the present pregnancy with cesarean scar ectopic gestation with a serum beta HCG of more than 1000 milli international units per ml. So she was given 4 doses of systemic injection methotrexate every alternate day along with folinic acid. Her repeat beta HCG was 897 milli international units per ml. So after that she was referred to Apollo hospitals for further tertiary care. We advised her transvaginal scan, so it showed that there was a resolving gestational sac of 1.6 into 1.2 centimeters with vascularity and a beta HCG of 422 milli international units per ml. We proceeded and she was given 4 doses of systemic injection methotrexate every alternate day along with folinic acid. Repeat beta HCG was 897 milli international units per ml. Further, she was referred to Apollo hospitals for tertiary care. So when she arrived, we asked for a transvaginal scan which showed a resolving gestational sac of 1.6 into 1.2 centimeters with vascularity and a beta HCG of 422 milli international units per ml. We proceeded with giving her again one more in dose of injection methotrexate and asked her to come after a week for a repeat transvaginal scan. So a repeat transvaginal scan showed a yolk sac of 2.8 cm into 2.1 cm in the LSCS scar, organized bleed of 2.5 cm into 2.1 cm around the sac with good vascularity, and a slight increase of beta HCG of 440 milli international units per ml. She was apprehensive and she complains of pain abdomen, so because of the failure of medical management, we decided to proceed with the surgical management. So we proceeded with the laparoscopic management. So, intraoperatively, a gestational sac of size 2.5 cm into 2.8 cm was seen at the lower segment. We proceeded with excision of the same lower uterine segment. The procedure went uneventful. Her repeat beta HCG was 246 milli international units per ml and it was negligible in 3 weeks. We advised her further sterilization. So, a brief discussion on the same topic. Incidence of cesarean scar pregnancy is rising due to the increased number of cesarean deliveries and good imaging techniques. Treatments include expectant management, medical and surgical management. Next. So, to early diagnosis would be through a sonography. So, the possible findings are empty uterus with clearly visualized endometrium, empty cervical canal, gestational sac within the anterior portion of the lower uterine segment, at presumed site of cesarean scar, tint or absent myometrium between the gestational sac and bladder less than 5 mm in 2 by 12 cases. Next, differential diagnosis, cervical pregnancy, normal thickness of the overlying, and it can be ruled out by normal thickness of overlying anterior myometrium, failed pregnancy through the lack of color flow on Doppler and a sliding organ site. Coming to the management, a termination in the first trimester is generally recommended in the literature. When there is progression towards abdominal cavity or bladder due to increased risk of life-threatening complications and loss of fertility. Coming to medical management, systemic methotrexate therapy or local injections of methotrexate or uterine artery embolization alone or uterine artery embolization with local methotrexate can be tried out. Surgical aspiration of gestational sac, hysteroscopic or laparoscopic, and open removal of the gestational sac is advisable. Next. So, surgical management with laparoscopy or laparotomy with excision of pregnancy may be the best for women who don't respond to conservative medical management, which had happened in our case, or are late to present. Next. Okay. Sonography combined with Doppler flow imaging is a very reliable tool for detecting. So, laparoscopic excision and repair provides great satisfaction in the management of cesarean scar pregnancies. The other thing is meticulous closure of the cesarean wounds has to be kept in mind. So hereby I conclude this. These are my references. Thank you.